Today in this lecture, we will talk about the volcano disaster. So what is a volcano? Volcano refers to the eruption of hot molten lava from below the surface of the earth, as you can see in this particular photo. A volcano is a vent in the earth's crust through which lava, steam, ashes, etc. are expelled. Now, what is this ring of fire? A zone along the edge of Pacific Ocean that has many volcanoes and earthquake. So you could see this particular dotted areas. Okay, they form the ring of fire. The horseshoe shape, the shape is like the horseshoe. The horseshoe shaped 40,000 kilometer long belt is characterized by higher volcanic activity. The ring of fire is a string of volcanoes that runs around the edge of the Pacific Ocean. See, this is the ring of fire. You could see this in this particular picture clearly. A string of 452 volcanoes stretches from the southern tip of South America up along the coast of North America, across the Bering Strait, down through Japan and into New Zealand. And thus it forms a ring of fire. Now, how are they? That is, how are the volcanoes formed? When tectonic plates collide and go through the process of subduction, compress each other, it sets the foundation for a volcano. The overlapping of the tectonic plates causes the magma to break through the crust, which is the cause of volcanoes' birth. So, as you know, the tectonic plates slide against each other, which is a natural phenomena which gives a shape to the earth. But when this overlapping of the tectonic plates take place and there is process of subduction, okay, it causes the magma to break through the crust, which is the cause of the volcano's birth. When temperature and pressure rises, the rock melts and moves through the surface and crust and releases gases, magma. Volcanic eruption occurs. So if you could see here, the magma chamber, the main vent, the side vent which emerges like a branch from the main vent, okay, smoke and ash and the lava which comes out from the volcano and a crater, a depression that is formed. And this is the earth's crust, of course. Then the narrow opening of a volcano is called vent. So this is the vent. Okay, inside the earth crust, there is this magma chamber and the vent. The upper part of the vent is a cup-shaped depression called the crater. Okay, the cup-shaped depression that is formed at the top, that is nothing but the crater or the crater cone, which is called as. The rock material ejected during the volcanic activity is deposited on the surface of the earth and it is called the lava, which forms the mountain of the volcano. Then pyroclastic flow. What is pyroclastic flow? It is the fluidized mixture of solid to semi-solid fragments that are emitted out from the volcano. It is characterized by hot expanding gases that flows down the flank of the volcanic edifice. Okay, so you could see here the magma chamber, the main vent, the secondary cone, the main cone which is nothing but the crater. Okay, the ashes form the ash clouds, the volcanic bombs, that is some solid fragments, okay, the lava flow and together which is called the pyroclastic flow, which is a combination of the solid and the semi-solid fragments that are emitted out from the volcano. Then pyroclastic flows are a mixture of hot gas, ash and other volcanic rocks traveling very quickly down the slope of the volcanoes. They are one of the most dangerous hazards posed by the volcanoes. Then several definitions in related to volcanoes we will see. Viscosity. So what is viscosity? The property of a fluid that resists the force tending to cause the fluid to flow. That is called the viscosity, the resistance to the flow of the fluid. Then magma, that is the molten material beneath or within the earth's crust from which this igneous rock is formed, that is called the magma. Lava, the molten fluid rock that issues from a volcano or volcanic vent. Ash, the powdery residue of the matter that remains after burning. Caldera, the large crater. See, here you could see it is a large depression. So, large crater formed by the volcanic explosion or by the collapse of a volcanic cone. So volcanoes can be in one of these three phases, that is active, dormant, and extinct. So what are these active, dormant, and extinct? We will see. Active volcanoes are the ones that have erupted in the past 10,000 years and they are likely to erupt again. The example is Mount St. Helens in USA. Dormant volcanoes are the ones that have not erupted in the past 10,000 years but still have the possibility, though unlikely. An example is the Mount Rainier in USA. And extinct volcanoes are the one which no eruption has occurred within the historic times and future occurrences are highly improbable. For example, the Mount Ashitaka in Japan. So this way, according to its likely occurrence, okay, they are divided into active, dormant and extinct volcanoes. Then there are different types of the volcanoes depending upon its characteristics. Okay, so the first is, if you could see this, the arrow, it's an arrow going downward, that is increasing violence, increasing viscosity. Okay, so as you move from one type to another, there is increase in the violence, there is increase in the viscosity of the fluid, that is the magma coming out. Okay, so the first type is flood or plateau basalt. Okay, so that volcano type, the characteristic is very liquid lava. So here you could see increasing viscosity. So as I will discuss one by one going down, the viscosity of that particular magma coming out from that particular volcano is going to increase and it has more increased violence. So the flood or plateau basalt is the first type where the characteristics is very liquid lava and flow is very widespread emitted from the fractures. For example, the river is the Columbia River Plateau and the diagram is given. It's a very simplified diagram. You could see it plain because the flow of the lava is very easy flow. Okay, then the shield volcano is the next type. The characteristic is liquid lava emitted from a central vent, large, sometimes has a collapsed caldera. So examples are large mountain, Mount Sylvania, Highland Butte, Hawaii volcanoes. Okay, and it looks like this in a simplified diagram. Then cinder cone, that is explosive liquid lava, small emitted from a central vent, if continued long enough, may build up a shield volcano. Then examples are Mount Tabor, Mount Zion, Chamberlain Hill, Pilot Butte, Lava Butte and craters of the moon, and it looks like this. Okay, then composite or stratovolcano, most viscous lava, much explosive pyroclastic debris are large emitted from a central vent. The examples are Mount Baker, Mount Rainier, Mount St. Helens, Mount Hood, Mount Shasta, and the simplified diagram looks like this. Okay, then the next is the volcanic dome, that is very viscous lava, relatively small, can be explosive, commonly occurs adjacent to craters of composite volcanoes. The examples are the Noarupta, the Mount Helens Lava Dome, Mount Lassen, Shastina, Mono Craters. These are the few examples and it looks like this. Very viscous lava, very difficult for the lava to spread out. Then the caldera, that is very large composite volcano, collapsed after an explosive period, frequently associated with plug domes. The examples are the Crater Lake, Newberry, Kilauea Long Valley, Medicine Lake, Yellowstone, etc. And it looks like this, collapsed volcano. Then, of course, in easy diagram, easy way see, you could see distinguish the type of volcano like this. This is a shield volcano. Just now what we have seen, the shield volcano, that is liquid lava emitted. Okay. Gentle slope of basaltic lava flows, vent and magma. Okay, this is a dome volcano. Sorry. So dome volcano, we have seen here, see the volcanic dome, very viscous lava. Okay, it can be explosive also. So it looks like this. Okay, that is the vent, the magma, steep convex slope from thick, fast cooling lava. Then you have a composite volcano. See, more viscous lava, much explosive. Okay, so see, This is more viscous than the composite. The dome volcano, in this, the viscosity is more of the lava than this, and therefore you have steep slopes as compared to the dome volcano in this composite volcano. You could see the slopes are steep. Okay, so you have wind and the magma coming out, branch pipe, ash, lava, etc. And then you have the caldera volcano, which looks like this. Here we have seen it, caldera, very large composite volcano collapse after an explosive. Okay, so it looks like a collapsed volcano. You have a very large caldera, old cone, okay, and the magma, new cone, ash, everything. Okay, so there are three major types, that is shield, composite, and cinder cone. Okay, we have seen various types, out of which the three major types are the shield volcanoes, the composite volcanoes, and the cinder cone volcanoes. So shield volcano, just now we have seen the same diagram, that is the magma inside a shield volcano is rich in iron and magnesium and is very fluid. Okay, that is the viscosity is very less, so it can easily flow. Since the magma is very fluid, the lava coming out of the volcano tends to flow greater distance, and that is why this slope is not that much steep. It is a gentle slope of basaltic lava flow. When shield volcanoes erupt, the flowing lava gives the volcano the shape of a gentle sloping mountain. That is the shield volcano. Then composite volcano, that is the magma inside the composite volcano is rich in silica and much thicker than the magma from a shield volcano. The gases trapped inside the thicker magma, eruptions from the composite volcano can be flowing lava or explosion. The explosive eruptions come from the trapped gases and produce the cinders, small size stones, and the ash. Okay, so this is how it looks. And the cinder cone volcano, that is the magma inside a cinder cone volcano, has large amount of gas trapped in it. Eruptions from cinder cone volcanoes are violent and explosive because of all the gases trapped in the magma. The large amount of hot ash and lava thrown out of the vent fall to the ground, forming the cone shape that these volcanoes have, and therefore it is called the cinder cone. It forms a cone-shaped mountain. Then, what are the causes of volcanic activity? So, when a part of the Earth's upper mantle or lower crust melts, the magma is formed. A volcano is essentially an opening or a vent through which this magma and the dissolved gases it contains are discharged. So, several processes associated with the mechanism of the volcanism are a gradual increase in the temperature with increasing depth at the rate of 1 degree Celsius for every 32 minutes. Gases and vapors are formed due to heating of the water, which reaches the underground through percolation. The ascent of magma forced by vast volume of gases and water vapor. The occurrence of volcanic eruption. So all these are the processes one by one, okay, which are related with the mechanism of volcanism. Then, what are the effect of volcanic eruption? The effect of volcanic eruption can be divided into primary and secondary effect. That is the immediate effect and the secondary effects. One effect, primary effect, leading to another secondary effect. The primary effect are immediate and come from the eruption itself. Okay, basically the eruption is what is responsible for it, the direct effect. Okay, and secondary effect result from the primary effect. So the primary effect of volcanic eruption are, first, the volcanic gases. All the magma contains dissolved gases. These gases are mainly steam, carbon dioxide, and compounds of sulfur and chlorine. Then lava flows. These are streams of molten rock. Pyroclastic flow. These are high-speed avalanche of hot ash, rock fragments, and gas which move down the sides of a volcano. These flows occur when the vent area or the ash column collapse. So this is hazardous. Okay, and this causes the primary effect. Then what are the secondary effect of volcanic eruption? Lahars, that is, these are mixtures of water, rock, ash, sand, and mud that originate from the slopes of volcano. Lahars often happen because of heavy rainfall eroding the volcanic deposits. So volcano does not have a direct effect on this flooding, but Because of the volcano and heavy rainfall, the eroding of the volcano deposit happens, and therefore this particular phenomenon occurs. Then landslide. Heat from cooling magma can cause hydrothermal alteration of the rocks, turning the sections of them into clay. This weakens the rocks and increases the risk of slow failure. So it is not the immediate effect, but it is the volcanic eruption has this indirect effect, that is landslide, due to hydrothermal alteration of the rocks. Then flooding. Explosive eruption can change the surface area around a volcano and disrupt the drainage patterns, leading to long-term flooding. Correct? Eruptions, explosions, okay, around the volcano, okay, the vibrations, the eruptions that are formed, that can disturb the drainage patterns and leading to long-term flooding. Other secondary effects include food and water supply interrupted, homelessness, people living nearby to this volcanic activity, businesses forced to close, cost of insurance claims, unemployment, long-term issues with the tourism industry. So, conclusion, that is, volcanoes are caused when molten rock, that is magma, flows out onto the earth's surface through fissures that are caused due to the movement of plates, that is the tectonic plates. Though volcanic eruptions are threats to human life, the areas where the eruptions have taken place are useful too. They have helped to create beautiful Hawaii Islands. These areas are rich in minerals. Volcanic eruption cause heavy damage to human life and property. Thank you.